for the best car, SUV, or truck. Guess what? You're in luck. Frontier Motors is down the street. Got the best deals that can't be beat. Don't overpay. Come in today. Doing business the old-fashioned way. Frontier. We've got the right price. Frontier. We'll treat you mighty nice. Frontier Motors. Low overhead country.
And we are pleased to have the owner of that establishment, often referred to as Low Overhead Country, with us live in the studio, ready, willing, and certainly more than able to provide you with valuable information, information that could help you determine the price of a car or a truck or an SUV that you're thinking of buying or selling or trading in. All you need to do is give us a call, 478-3116 here at WCOA, and you'll have the opportunity to speak with Ivan Streckel, the owner of Frontier Motors, 478-3116. Good morning, sir.
Hey, Don. Thanks so much for the introduction. And once again, we are having a double format. What that means, that we are live on the radio right now at 1370 AM radio, going on our 20th year with 1370. We're also videotaping this for our Blab TV customers. So if you're watching this on TV, there's no need to call in. There is a number on the bottom of your screen if you need the information that we're presenting here to the COA listeners, which again, this is a live call-in show for WCOA AM radio. And you can dial 478-3116. And the reason you'd want to call the radio show is because this is a show about advice. Advice as far as what you should pay for a particular car if you're in the market. Or better yet, what if you're going to buy a brand new car and you want to know what's my car worth right now? There's a couple of ways that we get you that information. Now, anybody can go on a computer and just Google used car values, and you're going to get a Kelley Blue Book and Edmunds and an NEDA value. We use a little bit different format here on COA and Blab TV. What we use is the Black Wholesale Guidebooks, and these Black Wholesale Guidebooks have been in the industry since I was a wee pup. I've gotten a car industry when I was about 15 years old, and I remember our sales managers. The salespeople were not allowed to have one of these books. Only the sales managers had one, and they had to keep them locked up in their top drawer. And the reason was because this told you what the dealers were paying for a particular car. Now, of course, the dealers don't want to share that information because they didn't want you to know how much they marked it up. So if this said that the wholesale value of a vehicle was $10,000 and the retail book said it was $15,000, well, that gave you a $5,000 spread. And that's a pretty big spread. Right now, the car business is so competitive that the dealers don't have the ability to make as much money per car as they used to do years ago when the customers weren't as educated as they are now. Now, how do the people get more educated? Well, obviously, it's the computer. Obviously, it's these smartphones right here. I have people use these where they're sitting in front of me. And what they're doing is I'll give them a price on a particular vehicle, and they're Googling it right there. What is the cost of a 2010 Ford Focus with 30,000 miles on it? And they're pulling up other dealerships' Ford Focuses. So the customers that we're dealing with are way more educated than they used to. And years ago, it wouldn't be unheard of that you could make $3,000 or $4,000 selling a car. And now the average on a used car is about $1,600. And the average on a new car that a dealer makes is even less than that. And what that means, it's good for you. It means that you're getting a good deal on a particular car because it is so competitive. We have a program at Frontier Motors called Price Driver. And what Price Driver does, it immediately tells me every vehicle that's for sale by any type of dealership. It doesn't give me all of the privates, but any dealership that has a vehicle for sale, whether it be on cars.com, on YouTube, on eBay, on Auto Trader, it's going to pop up that car. So if you're in the market to buy a 2004 Corvette, which by the way, we have a 2004 Corvette that we took in trade, I can tell within a matter of seconds every 2004 and 2005 Corvette within 150 mile radius. So that way, when I give you the price, I'm going to be assured that if you're not ready to buy right now and you want to do some shopping, that I've got the best deal out there. So if I gave you a price of, let's say, $20,000 on that car, I better make darn sure that that's a good price. Because if it's not, you won't be back. If it is a good price, you will be back. Now, it doesn't necessarily always have to be the least expensive price. But if mine's $20,000 and I've got 40,000 miles on my 2004 model car, that's pretty darn low miles on a car that's going on 12 years old. if a car's out there, it's the same price and has 60,000 miles, I'm probably going to win that sale. If I've got an automatic with electric seats and a double electric seats, heads-up display and navigation, and it's the same price as another car, I have more equipment, I'm probably going to get that sale. Or if my car is absolutely perfect and the other one is not. So those are the three major things that customers look for, other than one thing that I haven't mentioned, and that's the color of the car. The number one reason a dealer loses or makes a deal is not so much the price, it's not so much the equipment, it's not so much the miles, it's the condition and the color. Those things go hand in hand. But if I've had people look at a particular color and say, and they walk the other way, and I say, what's the matter? This car is exactly what you're looking for. Oh, it's burgundy. I hate burgundy. Or it's black. I hate black. Or it's white. I don't want another white car. I've had five white cars. So color is very important. And the interesting thing is that both of the books that we use to appraise cars, and this is the book, the official NADA guidebook, this is the book the bankers use, it never asks you the color of the car. As a matter of fact, the interesting thing is, it never even asks you the condition of the car. It never test drives the car. It doesn't ask you if it's got a clean history report or a bad history report. It doesn't ask you if the vehicle is still under factory warranty or if it's out of warranty. What if it's a car that's 3 years old and 1 month and it happens to be a Chevrolet? Well, Chevrolet only has a 3-year warranty. And it could be a 2012 model, but it could be an early 2012. Heck, it could even be a 13 because the 16s are out. So you could have a 13 model that might still have 8 months of factory warranty left, and you could have a 13 model that was an early one that might have no warranty left. Now, don't you think that has a little bit to do with the value of the vehicle? So there's all kinds of things that I can help you with as far as giving you advice on what you should pay for a car based on all of these parameters. And that's one of the things that we do at Frontier Motors, is we do what we talk about on the radio and TV show. And if we ever do not do that, what I'm talking about right now, you make sure you let me know. My name's Ivan, and I've been at Frontier Motors since it was born. I'm the owner of Frontier Motors. We're going on our 20th year in business. We started out with about 30 cars. We have 350 cars approximately in inventory. It varies from day to day, but that's about the average amount of vehicles that we carry. And the advantage of being an independent dealer, folks, is that we don't sell one make and model. I talk about this when we do the 1370 radio show all the time, is the biggest advantage that we have of being a non-franchise dealer is that we don't have to sell just what our franchise is. If you are a Ford dealer, you can only sell new Fords. If you go to World Ford, if you're looking for a new vehicle, you can't buy a new Chevy there. You can only buy a Ford there. Doesn't make it a bad sense. Dealership. Yeah. If you were going to buy a brand new Ford, I would definitely recommend that you buy it from our local dealer, which happens to be World Ford. But that's all they sell if you're buying brand new. And I bet you that when you flip over to the used car lot, they probably have more used Fords than any other make and model. Which is probably the same thing that if you go across the street and you go to, let's say, the Astro Lincoln Mercury dealership, which if you're going to buy a brand new Lincoln, I was going to say Mercury, it just flows off my tongue, Astro Lincoln Mercury.
Right,
well,
right.
Mercury hasn't been around since 2011. I feel bad for them because they used to have two makes and models. Now they only have one. But if you're going to buy a brand new Lincoln, you go to the Lincoln dealership. That's where you go to buy a brand new Lincoln, but that's all they sell. Now, if you come to Frontier Motors, and you're looking for a mid-sized car, I would show you the Ford Fusion. I would show you the Ford Taurus. And then you say, well, what about a Lincoln? You don't have to go to the Lincoln store. I've got the 2015, maybe even 2016 Lincoln MKZ and the MKZ sitting right there, which is their mid-size and their large car. So or the MKS. Actually, that's their large car. They make three different levels of cars. So the nice thing is I've got them all there. And while you're there, what if you want to look at a Lexus? I've got the ES350 and I have the LS460, which is their midsize car and their big car. If you want to look at the Infiniti, we have the G37 right there. If you flip over to BMW, we have a 3 Series and a 5 Series sitting right there. And we have them. I can just go on and on and on. And the advantage being is that we don't have to sell you one particular car. If you come on the lot and say, well, I want to look at a BMW and I don't want to look at a Mercedes, you're not going to make me mad because I'm not a Mercedes dealership. So I don't have to spend the rest of my day talking you into a Mercedes. It doesn't matter to us. We would just hope that you would buy one of our cars, whether it be a BMW, whether it be a Mercedes, or whether you flip over to Jaguar or Lexus or an Acura. We have them all. So the pressure is off. What I mean by pressure is that you know what the pressure feels like when you go to a used car dealership or a new car dealer for that matter. Matter of fact, it's even worse on new car dealers sometimes. They feel they only get one shot at your business. So they put a lot of pressure on to make sure that you buy there because they feel that you're never going to come back. Well, I think that's a fallacy. I think that if you run into a dealer and you like the dealer, what I mean by the dealer is obviously the first person you come in contact with is a salesman. So you'd hope that you'd find a salesman that you're going to like. Number two, you hope you like the dealer. Just the ambience of the dealership sometimes makes a difference. Are they kind of stuck up, so to speak, or they have a loosey-goosey attitude, like they're all having fun, everybody's doing business, they're not putting pressure on you. And that's what I'm talking about, that when you come in, you don't get that feeling like, I got to buy something today. I got this feeling from this particular dealer that they really are happy that I'm here. They're going to give me all the information that I want, and they're actually going to let me leave. And that's what we do at Frontier Motors. Obviously, we'd love you to buy a car the first time in, but we also realize that a lot of people, they want to take their time when they make the second largest purchase of their lives. The number one being, of course, a home, and number two normally being a car. Unless you're lucky enough to have an airplane or a boat or something like that, it's normally going to be number two is going to be a car. So it's an important purchase, and it's a purchase that right now most people make every 11.2 years, and that's the average life of a car on the road right now in the nation. Is 11.2 years. So you don't do this all the time. So when you do it, you want to make sure you do it right. Now, how do you do it right? You stop in at Frontier Motors and you get advice. We have the new car cost guides right here. That gives me every invoice that you could use. In the back of Consumers Reports, I get the Consumers Reports, by the way, in the back of Consumers Reports, they sell you an invoice, and the invoice that they sell you is $14.95. You can buy an invoice from Consumers Reports for just about $16, including tax. Well, Frontier Motors, you can get that invoice for nothing. Now, why would you need an invoice if you're going to buy a new car? You don't really have to have it, but if you know what the dealer paid, it makes it easier to negotiate a deal where you're not spending times of countless hours there trying to figure out what are you going to pay for this car. If I tell you the dealer paid $21,500 for the car, doesn't that make it a little bit easier for you to make a legitimate offer on that car? And the other thing that you're going to want to know is what's my car worth? Get that second opinion before you take their opinion. It takes 15 minutes to stop at Frontier Motors, and we will tell you, here's what we'll write you a check for. Here's what we'll buy you a car for, even if you don't buy a car from us. And these are just some of the things that we offer, and I'm going to talk about some of the other things that we offer. But really what this show is about is two things. It's talking about the car industry, what's going on in the car industries. I just mentioned that the average age of a used car on the road right now is 11.2 years. Of course, that might not be used to you because you might have bought it brand new. Well, it's used now. And we also talked about the fact that I can help you with getting the price of a new car. I can help you with the price of a used car. We talked a little bit about the fact that if you want a free appraisal, you stop at Frontier Motors. If you've got a car that you want to sell, you stop at Frontier Motors. But I think the biggest thing that sets us apart from the competition is how we treat our customers when they come in. We talk about the fact that we don't put a lot of pressure on our customers when they come in. That doesn't mean we don't want you to buy a car. We just don't make you want to feel like you're obligated to buy the car. A lot of the customers that we get back into the dealership, and I did a survey last year, and we put a pencil to what's happening at Frontier Motors after being in business for 19 years last year, is that 70% of our customers are repeat buyers. When I mean repeat or referrals. They either bought a car here before or somebody referred them to Frontier Motors. Now, that might not be unheard of in the new car industry when you're selling brand new cars. You can't hardly screw up a deal other than be treated unfairly when you're selling new cars because the cars are all perfect, right? That's why you buy a new car. Everything's perfect. Well, it's not so sometimes with used cars. So to have a 70% repeat or referral business in a used car dealership is unheard of. It's extremely high. And the reason it's high is because what happens when you come on the lot? What happens is that all of our salespeople unlock every car door every morning. We can give you a price list if you want to shop by yourself. It looks like this a little bit. We can give you a price list that our salespeople can give you so you can shop at your leisure. You can sit at every car. You don't have to be sold a car. You can just pick one out. And of course, if we're asking $21,900 for the car, your next question might be, well, Ivan, is that the best you can do or do you have a little bit more play on that? And I'll look at my dealer costs. Sometimes that's the best I can do. Sometimes I've got a little bit of leeway. Sometimes there's a trade-in, so I'm going to look at your trade-in. I'm going to give you a bottom-line price. But it's how you're treated that it makes such a difference when you come on the lot. And, Don, I think we've got a couple of testimonials that I brought along that tell the story a little bit about Frontier Motors, because we send a survey to our customers, and week after week we get these surveys back, and I'm always astounded. I had, for 6 weeks in a row, Don, I had 100% on our surveys. We rate them either 75% or 50%. If you do something wrong, you're going to get a 50% or 75%. But week after week, I'm getting 100% survey, and I think you've got a couple in there. I just want to go through some of them to let the folks that are listening or watching kind of understand the program of what we have here at Frontier Motors.
Sure. This is from Cynthia. She says, thanks to Jake for making my very first car buying experience in 10 years so great. Now I know why my parents keep coming back to buy their cars from you all. Thanks and Merry Christmas. Let's see. Jimmy. Jimmy said, I just purchased my second vehicle from you at Frontier. I love the no hassle and the no high pressure sales reps that you guys have. RJ was my salesman on both sales. He remembered me from nearly 2 years ago. This speaks volumes for the quality of service at your dealership. Let's try Daniel. Charlene, the salesperson, was sensational. She sold me a car about 5 years ago. It was such a pleasant experience that I went back to see her to purchase my next vehicle. He's not by himself. How many have I got now? Six or seven, I think. Once again, she was exceptionally accommodating to my many questions. She let me test drive it. I will continue to come to Frontier Motors first for any vehicle that I plan to purchase in the future. I love the service. I love the relaxed feelings that I have when purchasing a car. Really top-notch service. I can't say enough about how great Charlene was to deal with. Thanks again. That was from Daniel. Here's Goodwood. Osgood. Osgood says, the selection of cars, vans, and trucks is huge at Frontier Motors. I was looking for a certain car and found it. All the people I dealt with at Frontier Motors were so friendly and very cheerful. Negotiations were handled in a very professional and easy manner. I might go back next week and get another car just so I can get another. Sorry, I almost said the magic word there. See, there's a special secret gift that you get when you purchase a car, and I really ought not to be revealing that. You could be overrun with new customers if I did that. Jack writes, Matt treated me with the utmost courtesy and respect. He's very professional. There were two or three minor issues that he addressed in a very timely manner. And could not have asked for any more in my truck buying experience. And the is also great, too. He means the secret gift that comes with most of the deals here. Sandra wrote, I have heard for years about Frontier Motors, and everything that I heard was absolutely true. Keep up the good work. Have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Do we have time for a long one, Ivan?
Yeah, we got one
more. All right, listen to this one.
Last one.
All right, this is Michael. Michael says, Robin Rainey, Charlene, and Darren were an amazing team. They worked really hard in getting us into a vehicle that suited our needs. We're extremely happy with our sales experience, the attention to detail, and the very kind personalities of the named employees. We were in a jam. We were extremely stressed out. They made us feel comfortable and eased the tension of car shopping, which, of course, can be considerable. I would say definitely purchase another vehicle from Frontier Motors. We will highly recommend Frontier Motors to all friends and family. Thank you all so much for your kindness, for your generosity, and for all of your hard work. Thanks again. And this is from Michael, actually from all of his family. So there you go.
Very good, Don. Thanks so much for reading those testimonials. And folks, I'm sure that every dealership has the same thing where they can pop out testimonials. But these are surveys that we get, and they compile all the data, and it's 100%, 100%, 100%, which is very difficult when you're selling used cars. Now, why is it more difficult when you're selling used cars? Because used cars break. What happens when they break? They blame the dealership, and they give you a bad rating. We make sure that when we sell a car, that we don't give you a car that's subpar. Now, anything can break. If you're selling a $75,000 car, something could go wrong. The starter motor could go wrong. Maybe the battery could go dead. All these things could happen. But when we sell the car, we do the best we can to make sure that that car is ready to go. And some dealerships could care less. Some dealerships actually do the opposite, where they hide things. And yesterday, which was on a Sunday, I took my bicycle and I went bicycling. And I stopped at six new car dealerships. I was very surprised that out of the six new car dealerships, five of them sold their used cars as is. I specifically went and looked at their Moroni window stickers, which is this window sticker that has to be attached to every used car by law in the state of Florida. You have to have that sticker on there. And the major reason for that window sticker is not have nothing to do with pricing. You don't have to put a price on the car, but you have to let the customers looking at it know what warranty is left. Every one of our cars right now gets a 3-month, 3,000-mile warranty. I lost confusion. Not three months, 300 miles. It's 3 months, 3,000-mile warranty on the drivetrain, automatically, as long as the car is less than 15 years old. So when you go to Frontier Motors cars, they're all going to be marked with warranties. Now, most of our cars, I don't have to worry about that warranty because they come with factory warranty. I'm looking at some of the cars that we have. We have a 2016 Subaru Forester on a lot, and that's 400 miles on. Well, it has... When I say full factory warranty, that would be a lie, because if the car is 2 months old, you lose 2 months of warranty. But the whole claim of fame at Frontier Motors is that we sell the alternative to new. And I've got an article here from Consumers Reports. It was in April of this year's edition of Consumers Reports on page 21. And it says that the average new car last year was $34,000, and the average depreciation in the first year, in other words, if you bought that car last year for $34,000, this year it would have dropped $9,180 in value. So that's what we deal in. We deal in that one car that's dropped that dollar amount, and then we put a small markup on it. You might still be able to save $6,000 to $7,000 on a one-year-old car. And we're talking about a Nissan Versa with 500 miles on it, a Ford Edge with 500 miles on it, a Silverado with 300 miles on it, a Chevy Camaro with 900 miles on it, a Nissan Quest with 1,000 miles on it, a 16 Toyota Tacoma with 1,600 miles on it. And folks, what we do with these cars is I've had people coming already on the Tacoma, for example. If we're asking $36,000 for that four-wheel drive Tacoma, if you come on the lot and say, well, you know, new ones like that, number one, you got to compare apples to apples. Don't forget, you can put $6,000 or $7,000 worth of equipment on a brand new car. So you might be comparing a base model with our loaded one. The other thing is, the only thing that I would ask everybody to do here is not look at asking prices alone. Look at the bottom line price. If you're going to shop a brand spanking new car, I don't care where you go, force that dealer to give you an out-the-door figure in writing with everything included. And make sure they include the tag. A brand new tag these days is around $400. A tag transfer is about $200. Include everything, the taxes, the title. If you owe money on your car, have them put that on there. So you only have to worry about one figure. Isn't that a lot easier to compare that one figure rather than, well, how much are you giving me for my car? What are the payments? What are the discounts? What are the rebates? What's the dock fee? How come you're charging all these fees? None of those fees matter. The asking price doesn't even matter. The only thing that matters is the bottom line price. And one of the things that we pride ourselves in at Frontier Motors is giving you a bottom line price in writing. We take a worksheet. We put all the information on there. We put the retail price, the trade-in value, the bottom line, the tax, the title, the dock fee, the amount of money that you owe on yours, the tag transfer, the title fee. Any type of fees will be on there. And we circle the bottom line and we give it to you. And we say, okay, our car is 6 months old. It's got 2,000 miles on it. Go compare that to a new one. Now, I better make sure I give you a good price. Because if it's the same price as a new one, I'm never going to see you again. I do a lot of research when I buy those cars to make sure I can save you enough money to make it worth your while. And on some cars, that might only be $3,000. On some cars, it's as much as $13,000 or $14,000. I know the extreme would be, I've got a Jaguar in stock right now. It's a 2015 Jaguar F-Type. It's the high-performance model. The window sticker on the car is $106,000, folks. This is an extreme example. The car's got 8,000 miles on it. I can sell that car right now for $82,000. Now, that's a lot of money for a car, isn't it? But can you imagine paying $106,000? You know what? They don't deal on Jaguars. If it's $106,000, that's pretty much what you pay. So you're comparing a car that might be 8 months old at $106,000, and the depreciation now is $24,000. $24,000 depreciation in 6 months. I think that's worth your while. If you're going to buy a car like that. Now, not everybody is going to buy a car like that. You could go lesser extreme. You could look at a 2014 pickup truck that might be $45,000 brand new that you can buy for $36,000 with 7,000 or 8,000 miles on. But the list goes on and on and on. The whole thing we're talking about here is give Frontier Motors a try for a couple of reasons. Number one, to see how much we can save you if you're going to buy a brand new car. If you're going to buy a brand new car, how much can we save you? Can we save you $7,000, $5,000 over a car that might be a 2016 or a 15, a car that smells like new, a car that has factory warranty left, a car that has never been in an accident, a car that's not been smoked in, a car that is got a lot more equipment than maybe what you even need because you're not paying extra for that equipment, and that our bottom line is that much less than the brand new car dealership. Now, let's say you don't want to buy that car. And no matter what I say, I can't convince you to buy a car with low miles on it. What about letting me look at your trade-in so that if you decide to go to Lexus of Mobile or the Acura dealership over in Mobile or the Jaguar dealership or the Land Rover dealership, now using those correlations because it's in Mobile, you got to go to get all those franchises so they don't get mad at me. But if you're going to buy a brand new Lexus, wouldn't it be nice to know what Frontier Motors would appraise your car for? That way, if you go to the Lexus dealership, you make your best possible deal. Now, on Lexus, they do deal a little bit. So if you're looking at a $50,000 Lexus, you might be able to get a $3,000 discount, as an example. So you're buying that car for $47,000. If I appraise your car for $27,000, your trade-in, now there's a $20,000 balance. But what if they only appraised your car for $23,000? Well, I'm giving you $4,000 more. And 2 weeks ago, we had a caller on the 1370 radio show here that said that I saved them $3,000 on the appraisal. They were going to go and buy a brand new car. I'm not going to mention the dealer's name. I don't want them any more mad at me than they already are. But my appraisal was $20,000, and the dealer's appraisal was $17,000. So the customer, what they did is they used my appraisal. They went and bought the new car, and then I'm supposed to buy it right from the dealer. I told them I'll buy it right from the dealership. Because if you trade the car, and for example, if you're buying a $20,000 car and you have a $20,000 trade-in, there's zero taxes. And that's how some dealers talk you into trading, because there's a tax benefit. But why not get the best of both worlds? Why not get the higher appraisal from Frontier Motors, still trade it at the dealer you want to do business with, and I'll just buy it right from the dealer for that figure? So if I give you a $20,000 appraisal, there's no reason to take less than that. Sometimes they'll try to talk you into it and say, hey, you're going to save some money if you buy through me, but I think you should get the best of both worlds. We've only got about 3 minutes left, so we want to talk about the industry a little bit. The car industry is the best it's ever been since I've been in the industry. This could be the best new car year they're ever going to have. There's only a week left in the year, and they might hit 17.2 million cars, which is a record, and I am so happy about so many new cars being sold, because what that means, that there's more used cars out there. And that means I get more share of those cars, and I'm able to buy those cars when they flood the market. They're coming down in value, which means I'm buying them cheaper, which means I can sell them cheaper. And that's really what makes me happy, is that I'm able to give a customer a good deal on a used car that might be 6 months old or a year old, or even maybe something that I've taken a trade on that six-month-old car that I can sell for $10,000. I've been talking about that we are the alternative to new, but we also have always 50 to 60 cars on the lot that I can sell for less than $10,000. So we don't have just the alternative to new. We also have very good used cars that have a lot of life left them that we check out the best we can to make sure.
Don't forget to like us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Check out our website at FrontierMotorsInc.com. 350 vehicles in stock, 31 detailed photographs from all of them at prices. Thanks for watching and listening to the Frontier Motor Show. Have a great day. Auf Wiedersehen.